Neurons are the fundamental building blocks of the nervous system. They are specialized cells that send and receive electrical signals, allowing us to think, move, and experience sensations. These cells communicate through electrical impulses. The two main states are the resting potential and the action potential. When a neuron is not sending a signal, it is in a state called a resting potential. It is characterized by a stable, negative charge inside the neuron compared to the outside. The membrane of the neuron is selectively permeable, meaning it allows some ions to pass through while blocking the others. This selective permeability is crucial for maintaining the resting potential. While at rest, the inside of the neuron has a lot of potassium ions and negatively charged molecules. The outside has many sodium ions. This is possible because the cell has a special mechanism called the sodium-potassium pump. The pump uses energy to move ions in and out of the cell. That is, it pumps 3 sodium ions out of the neuron and 2 potassium ions into the neuron. Because more positive ions are pumped out than brought in, the inside of the neuron becomes negatively charged compared to the outside. This difference in charge is called a resting potential, which is usually about negative 70 millivolts. Now, a neuron needs a specific amount of positive charge in order to conduct an electrical impulse, or what we call an action potential. The external stimulus brings a positive charge to excite the neuron, but what happens is that the neuron just doesn't get excited so easily. It needs a specific amount of positivity to carry the impulse. This critical level where the neuron agrees to carry the impulse is called the threshold, which is around negative 55 millivolts. If this level is not reached, the potential is called the graded potential, meaning that the neuron is not excited to that extent and it will not conduct the impulse. But what happens if the level is reached? Well, then the neuron fires and an action potential is set to occur. At this point, the sodium channels in the neuron's membrane open and positively charged sodium ions rush in. The influx of sodium ions causes depolarization, where the inside of the neuron becomes more positive, rising towards positive 30 millivolts. This change in voltage travels along the neuron, sending the electrical impulse down its axon. After reaching this peak, the neuron needs to return to its resting state. This process is called repolarization, and it occurs when the sodium channels close and potassium channels open, allowing the positively charged potassium to flow out of the neuron, bringing the membrane potential back to the negative value. Sometimes the membrane potential goes slightly more negative than the resting potential, a phase known as hyperpolarization. This occurs because potassium channels remain open a bit longer than necessary, allowing extra potassium ions to flow out of the neuron. Once hyperpolarization occurs, the potassium channels gradually close, stopping the excess outflow of ions. This helps to stabilize the membrane potential, preventing it from becoming even more negative. The sodium-potassium pump comes into play here. It helps restore the resting potential by pumping sodium ions out of the neuron and potassium ions into the neuron. Eventually, what happens is that the neuron returns to its resting potential of negative 17 millivolts, ready to fire another action potential if stimulated again. Now, we are going to discuss two types of refractory periods: absolute refractory period and relative refractory period. This one occurs during the repolarization. It is the period of time when a neuron cannot fire another action potential, no matter how strongly it is stimulated. The other one occurs during hyperpolarization. While the sodium channels could open, it would take a larger than usual stimulus to reach the threshold because the cell is hyperpolarized. Hope you enjoy. Thanks for watching.